Composite materials are basically a combination of two or three materials or even more that when combined with each other, it will give you properties that are better than individual materials. And nowadays you can think of fiberglass, carbon fibers. We can find it in our home appliances, in our skis, you know, the other sporting goods, in our automobiles, in the aerospace components, marine and so on. These materials have found a lot of interest by industries, but there are still several questions to be answered as far as how this material behave under different loading conditions, how we should manufacture them so that we don't have problems. My research focus actually is in twofold. One is the composite materials. I'm working on modeling, simulation and optimization of composite materials. And my secondary field of research is on the multi-criteria optimization and decision-making for complex engineering systems. I'm Abbas Milani, a faculty member at the School of Engineering, UBC Okanagan. Our composites lab at the Okanagan campus of UBC is part of the Composites Research Network, or CRN. This network was established in 2012 by the government of Canada in order to help the manufacturers to go towards more effective and risk-free design and manufacturing of the composites. When engineers do design, normally requirements of the final product is not a single, basically, objective. For example, a product we make like this, say in the bridge deck slabs, we want to be mechanically durable, but at the same time we want to make sure it's not degrading over environmental conditions, so we have multiple objectives to meet. The main excitement about composite is, if I want to compare it to other materials like the metals or cements, there are a combination of the materials there, so as much as it allows you to customize your design. You may say, I want the properties in a particular direction or in a particular environmental condition to perform this way, so you can basically customize that from the beginning by choice of the correct components of composites. But the challenge, I think, which I think for me is the interesting part as a researcher, is that then how you want to process those materials that in the beginning you choose, so that as your composite part, say something like this, is formed, the properties that you had in mind is met at the end. So this, I think, state of complexity, research-wise, is a challenge and excitement for me. And for a manufacturer, it still is a big question mark and dilemma. And here at UBC Okanagan, we are really delightful that we can work with industry members, over 50 companies almost, we are collaborating to solve this type of problems for them.
How they are applying the load like this.